A very good morning to all the students. This video for the class 6 subject science. This is your chapter number 6, that is changes around us, and this is your lecture number 4. In today's lecture we will be covering the summary of this chapter. So let's start with the first activity. So, in activity first, we have to take a balloon and blow it. Then take care that it doesn't burst. So, the shape and the size of the ball of the balloon have changed. Now, let the air escape the balloon. The question that is arising here, was it possible to get the balloon back to its original shape and size? Is it possible? You need to observe this while you performing this activity. Is it possible to get the balloon back to its original shape and size? So the answer of this activity, yes, we can change the shape and the size of the balloon because this is a reversible change. Let's move on the next activity, second activity. Here, take a piece of a paper and fold it as in the form of aeroplane. You have to change the sheet of a paper into toy aeroplane. So, you may have lots of fun in flying this plane. Then, once you are tired of it, then unfold the paper again. You need to observe the activities. What will be the conclusion of this activity? Take your time. So, the question that is arising here, was the size of the paper same as before and after making an aeroplane? Was it possible? So, the answer is yes, the size of the paper will remain same because it's a reversible change. Or the change in the shape and the size is a physical property, or a change in the physical property, that is a reversible change. Now let's move on to the next activity, activity number 3. Here, take some dough and make a ball. Try to roll out a roti from that dough. Maybe you are not happy with its shape and wish to change it back into a ball of a dough again. So the question that is arising from this activity, was it possible to get back the ball of a dough again? So yes, it is possible to get back the ball of dough again. Because it's a reversible change. We can revert back the ball of a dough again. Okay? From all these three activities, it is clear that the change can be reversed. Such changes in which the object or material can be obtained back in their original form by changing their condition are called as reversible change. Reversible changes are those changes. Change can be reversed, or reversible changes are temporary changes. So the material can be obtained back in their original form by changing their condition. So here are the few examples of the reversible change. So the first example is melting of butter. Or melting of ice cream, or melting of ice is also an example of reversible change. In melting of butter, you can change the solid butter into a liquid form. And again, the liquid butter gets freezed and it's got converted into the solid form. So it's a reversible solid to liquid and liquid to again solid. Next we have the fourth activities over here. In a fourth activity, take the same balloon which you used in activity first. Then blow it to its full size and tie its mouth with a string tightly. Then prick it with the pointed tip of your pencil or pen. Then what will happen? It's burst out. So the question that is again arising here, was it possible to get the balloon back to its original shape and size? You need to perform the fourth activity and observe the observation from that activity. Okay? So now we have the fifth activity here. In fifth activity, take the same piece of a paper which you used in activity second and draw an aeroplane on it and cut along its outline. And the question that is arising here from this activity, was the size of the paper same as before and after? Okay, take your time and write the observation of fourth activity and also this fifth activity in your notebook. At last we have the sixth activity over here, that is roll out a roti from the ball of a dough again and bake it on a tawa. So the question of this activity is, was it possible to get back the ball of a dough again? So you need to perform all these activities. Next topic is, what do you understand by change? Second topic is classification of changes. And there are some parts under the second topics, fast and slow changes. What is fast and slow changes? Second, reversible and irreversible changes. Next, desirable and undesirable changes. What do you understand by desirable change and undesirable change? Next, we have the periodic and non-periodic changes. Then second topic of the fifth part is physical and chemical changes. Next topic is endothermic and exothermic changes. Oh, what are endothermic changes and exothermic changes? And the next topic is changes caused by expansion and contraction of materials. At last, we have the homework solution of lecture number 1. So let's start with the first topic of this chapter, that is, what do you understand by changes? So let's start with the first topic of this chapter. What do you understand by change? To make a difference in the state or change in the condition of a thing or replace the another state or replace the another condition is known as change. Change take place in our body as well. When increasing in height and increasing in weight, it's also a change. Growth of hair and nails and a baby growing into an adult stage are also an example of a change. So changes happen around us all the time. There are the various reasons for the changing taking place. For example, day and night occur due to the rotation of the earth, or balloon grow the bigger in the size when the air is blown into it. These are also changes that happen around us all the time. So the next topic we have, classification of changes. Changes can be grouped as follows are here. Let's start with the first change. Fast changes and slow changes. Changes take place over a short duration of a time are called as fast changes. Or the changes that take a longer duration, for example, taking the day, complete day, taking a several months or even years, are called as slow changes. Here, the example of slow changes and fast changes. Burning of a piece of a paper is a fast change because it burned very fast. Changing the shape of a balloon by squeezing it is also a fast change. Growing of a baby into an adult form, that is a slow change. And growing of a hair, it's also a slow change. Moving on our next topic, that is reversible and irreversible changes. We had already done some activities related to this topic, that is reversible and irreversible change. The activity number 4, 5 and 6. It's clear that some changes cannot be reversed from these activities. So, reversible changes are those changes which can be reversed easily. But changing the physical condition are called as reversible changes. So, reversible change is a temporary change. For example, dissolving, melting and folding are the example of reversible change. For example, melting of ice, melting of butter is reversible change. In reversible change, there is no new substance is formed or it's a temporary change. Or we can say that the change which can be reversed easily by changing the physical conditions are reversible change. Next we have the irreversible changes. Irreversible change are those change which cannot be reversed by changing the physical conditions are called as irreversible changes. All the irreversible change is a permanent change. In irreversible change, always a new substance is formed. So, burning of a substance is an example of irreversible change, or burning of candle, falling of leaves from the tree, or formation of the curd into from the milk, and breaking of an egg. These are the example of irreversible change. Now, moving on, the third part of the second topic is desirable and undesirable changes. Here, desirable change are which change? Change which are for our benefits are desirable changes. For example, cooking of food, ripening of fruits, and changing of seasons are desirable changes. But the irreversible changes result in the formation of a new materials which may be desirable. For example, milk turning into curd and formation of compost from the cow dung and vegetable waste are example of the formation of new substance. And this kind of a irreversible change is desirable change. Okay? Breaking of glass, rotting of the food, flooding of a river are irreversible. But also a undesirable change. So, next we have the undesirable changes. Undesirable changes are those changes which are harmful for us, are known as undesirable changes. Here are the example of undesirable changes: flood, drought, and accidents are the undesirable change. But breaking of a glass, rotting of a foot, and the flooding of a river are irreversible but undesirable also. So a change is desirable sometime and undesirable at other time. For example, burning of a fuel to get the heat and light is desirable change, and burning of a factory or a burning of a house is undesirable change. So burning of a house is harmful for us, so it's an undesirable change. Burning of a fuel to get the heat and the light is a desirable change. Okay, it's for our benefit. So change is desirable sometime and undesirable at the other time. Sometime with desirable change and undesirable change also occur. Where it occur? For example, production of electricity in the powerhouse is a desirable change because it's useful for us. But burning of a coal to produce electricity produce smoke, which is harmful for us. So it's undesirable. Okay? So moving on, a fourth part of a second topic, that is periodic and non-periodic changes. Here the periodic changes which occur after the regular interval of a time are called as periodic change. For example, the phase of a moon, heartbeat, and the tide in the sea water are the periodic changes. As you can see here, different phase of a moon. Here the changes in a regular interval. How the phase of a moon changes, or how it's a periodic change? Because it takes the two duration of the time, first for the 14 days, second for the another 14 days. It takes a whole month for complete its cycle of changes of shape. Okay? Next, we have the changes, physical and chemical changes. Physical changes in which the basic composition of a substance doesn't change or new materials formed. No new material is formed is physical change. Physical change here, the shape and the size and state of a substance may change. For example, evaporation and condensation of water, stretching and relaxing of a rubber band, or making a paper boat, it's also a physical change because we can revert back the paper into its original form. Then drawing of pulp are some example of physical change. Physical changes are usually reversible. Next, we are going to talk about some chemical changes here. Chemical changes in which new substances are formed. New substances are formed that are possess the different properties. For example, curdling of milk, cooking of food, ripening of fruit, and rusting of iron. When the iron objects are left exposed to moist air, or when the iron object reacts with the water in the damp air, a reddish brown covering of rust is formed on the surface of iron. So the chemical changes are usually in irreversible. Moving on, next topic, that is endothermic or exothermic changes. Here in endothermic, the change which takes place by absorbing the heat is called as endothermic change. For example, evaporation of water occurs by absorbing heat from the surrounding. Okay. Let us take another example to understand this endothermic change. When we keep ice cube in a bowl on a table, then they melt without heating. Can you tell me how does it happen? Think. Because ice absorbs heat from the atmosphere and melts. So the change which takes place by the absorbing heat is endothermic change. Next we have the exothermic changes. Here change in which heat is given out is exothermic change. For example, when the fuel is burnt, it gives out some heat. Another example is when a cup of a hot tea that becomes cold by giving out the heat to the atmosphere. It's another example of exothermic change. Okay. Now, let's move on to the last topic of this video or this lecture. That is changes caused by expansion and contraction of material. So, what do you understand by the expansion and contraction? Here, expansion means increase in size of an object due to heating is expansion. And the contraction is decreasing in size of an object on cooling is contraction. So, the solid, liquid and gases, all changes on heating. Heating can expand them, but the amount of expansion differs in solid, liquid and also in gases. Gases expand the most, while the solid expand the least. Cooling causes material to contract. So, solid contract the least, while the gases contract the most. Here, the expansion and the contraction in solids. Most of the solids expand on heating, but on cooling, they come back to their original size. So, as you can see here in this picture, it's an iron ring. Outside the is iron ring and the inner, these are wood cart. Iron rim on a cart wheel. In this case, the wheel is made up of, this wheel is made up of wood. And the rim, these are the rim that is made up of iron. So the iron rim is made slightly smaller than the diameter of the wheel. So, when we heat this, expand and fit on the wooden wheel. Then on cooling, it fits tightly around the wheel, this iron rim. When we cool this, it fits tightly around the wheel. So this is expansion and contraction in solid. Next we have the expansion and contraction in liquid. For example, in clinical thermometer used for measuring the body temperature. This is the clinical thermometer. Here, the bulb of thermometer contains the mercury, which expand on absorbing heat from the body. Then as a result, the level of mercury, it rises in the glass tube, thereby indicating the temperature. If the bulb of the thermometer is dipped in the cold water, then the liquid contract. And the level of mercury in the glass tube falls from the above. We conclude that the liquid expands on heating and contract on cooling. Next we have the expansion and contraction in gases. For example, balloon in a hot water or balloon in a cold water. As you can see here, this inflated balloon inside a room bursts more frequently in the summer than in winter. How? Because the heat causes the air inside the balloon to expand at the room temperature, and then this balloon bursts out. This shows that the gas expands on heating. If an inflated balloon is tied at the mouth of a bottle and the bottle placed in the cold water, what will happen? Then the balloon shrink in the size. This is because the air inside the balloon contract on cooling.
We will be discussing some NCERT exercise question, that is on a page number 51. So let's start with the first question. So the question number 1 is to walk through a waterlogged area. You usually shorten the length of your dress by folding it. Can this change be reversed? I'm repeating the question. To walk through a waterlogged area, you usually shorten the length of your dress by folding it. Can this change be reversed? So the answer is yes, that change can be reversed back. When you walk through the waterlogged area, we actually cannot increase or decrease the length of the dress. But by folding the some part of the dress, that part of the dress shortens, but by unfolding that dress, it can be back into the length of the dress again. So here, change that can be brought back into its shape, this change is termed as reversible change. Moving on, our second question, that is, you accidentally dropped your toy and then you broke it. This change you didn't want to. Can this change be reversed? When you accidentally drop your toy and broke it, this change you didn't want, can this change be reversed? So the answer is, this change cannot be reversed, because if a toy is broken, then it cannot be brought back to its original shape. Thus, this change cannot be reversed back. Okay, the change that can be reversed back by the reversible process or under some any other process is termed as reversible changes. Okay, in reversible changes is a process whose direction can be reversed by the bringing the small changes. But here the toy is broken, so it cannot be reversed back to its shape and size. But by applying any other process, such as by glue or any other thing, we can get the toy again. Okay, so next, moving on our third question, that is, some changes are listed in the following table. For each change, you have to fill the blanks of the column whether the change can be reversed or the change can not be reversed. Okay, so the first is the sawing of a piece of a wood. Is the change can be reversed or not? So the answer is no. The sawing of a piece of a wood means cutting off wood. Once the wood cut, cannot be reversed back to its form. So the change is irreversible change. Next is the melting of ice candy. So the answer is yes, this change is reversible change. In the melting of ice, here in the melting of ice candy, there is a change in the state of a metal, that is from solid, this candy is solid, it changes into liquid state, and it can be reversed back by using the reversible process. Okay, we can change its shape and the size of this candy. So then say yes, we can change it, their shape and size. Next we have dissolving sugar in water. So the answer is yes, dissolving sugar in water can be reversed back. So it's a reversible change. Next we have the cooking of food. So the answer is no, because while cooking of a food, the property of the ingredients and substance get changes, which make it impossible to recover the original ingredient back. Okay, therefore this is the reason the cooking of food is a irreversible change. Next is the ripening of a mango. So the answer is no, we cannot change the mango, because when the mango get ripened, it cannot be reversed back to the original mango that was used using reversible process. Okay, next we have the souring of milk. Souring of milk is also a irreversible change. When the milk gets soured in taste, it cannot be reversed back to its original taste again. So the change occurred is irreversible change. Moving on, a fourth question, that is question number 4. Here, a drawing sheet changes when you draw a picture on it. Can you reverse this change? A drawing sheet changes when you draw a picture on it. Can you reverse this change? Can you? So the answer is yes, the change can be reversed or not be reversed. We can change it or we cannot be reversed it. Okay. For example, suppose if we draw a picture on a drawing sheet with a pencil, then we can erase it with this picture with the help of eraser and get the original blank sheet. Okay, in this case the change can be reversed. But suppose if we draw some picture on a drawing sheet with a pen or a color. Then what happens? Such as watercolor or anything color, any color, crayon color, wax color, you can use it any color. Then what happens? We cannot erase the picture now and cannot be obtained back to the blank sheet again. Okay, in this case the change cannot be reversed. In the first case, the change can be reversed while we drawing a picture on a drawing sheet with a pencil, but in a pen case we cannot be reversed. Okay, moving on a fifth question. You have to give the example to explain the difference between changes that can or cannot be reversed. Okay, so the following examples that explain the difference between changes and that can or cannot be reversed are, so the first example is, if we fold piece of a paper, then there is a change in the shape, change in their size also. But if we unfold that piece of a paper, then it can be obtained back to its original shape and size using the reversible process. Thus, if this change occurred is a reversible change. But piece of a paper, then it cannot be reversed back to its original shape and original size using the reversible process. So there is a change occurred as irreversible change. We cannot make the original paper from these piece of a paper. Okay, so it's a irreversible change. So sixth question is, a thick coating of a paste of a plaster of Paris or POP is applied over the bandage on a fractured bone. It becomes hard on drying to keep the fractured bone immobilized. So can the change in POP be reversed? Is it possible? Can we change in POP? So the answer is, the change in the plaster of Paris cannot be reversed. Okay, because on hydration of the plaster of Paris, it forms a solid compact. Thus, it is not reversed back to its original form using any process. So, it's an irreversible change. Plaster of Paris is an irreversible change. We cannot change it. Okay. Moving on, our last question of this chapter. That is, a bag of a cement lying in the open gap gets wet due to rain during the night. The next day, the very next day, the sun shines brightly. Do you think the changes which have occurred in the cement, could it be reversed? So the answer is, the change in the cement could not be reversed. Because on being hydration and kept for the drying the cement, it forms a solid compact substance such that it do not reverse back to its original form using any process. So this is an irreversible change. This is your homework of lecture number 4. What you have to do, you have to solve the assignment that have been uploaded on the AdGuard site. Okay, you can check the assignment from the AdGuard site. Solve this assignment and send this assignment up to 7 p.m. in the evening.